Pramani Vikramasekara, and I'm really happy to see you all. Okay, children, before the lesson, I would like to give you a task. Look at the board. You can see situations and results. First of all, you have to match the given situation with relevant result. Okay, please take 1 minute and do the task. Okay, I hope you have completed the task. Let's go one by one and please check your answers whether you are correct or wrong. Okay, first situation, do regular exercises. Do regular exercises, then what will be the result? Yes, be healthy. Okay, number two, it rains. Result? Get wet. Three, drink a lot of milk. Result? Strong bones. Then the fourth one, eat a lot of sweets. Then what's the result? Yes, correct. Become overweight. Get wet. Result, catch a cold. Last one is go to the pharmacy, buy a roll of bandage. Okay, right? Now we have completed matching tasks. Now I want you to combine these two parts and make sense. Combine these two parts. Do regular exercise. Be healthy. These are two separate clauses. Now we have to combine these and make one sentence. How do you do that? Okay. Now, please turn to page number 96 in your pupil's book. Page number 96 in the pupil's book. Look at the sentences given there. Please study them. If we do regular exercises, we will be healthy. Number two, if it rains, we will get wet. Number three, if you drink a lot of milk, you will have strong bones and teeth. Number four, if you eat a lot of sweets, you will become overweight. Fifth one, if you get wet, you will catch a cold. Number six, if I go to the pharmacy, I will buy a roll of bandage. Okay, I think you may have noticed that these phrases are used in these examples. Now you can study how these sentences are formed. Okay, let's take the first one. I gave you these two clauses. Do regular exercises, be healthy. Now we are going to make a sentence as given in your pupil's book. What's the sentence? If we do regular exercises, we will be healthy. Okay. We call these types of sentences as conditional sentences. Conditional sentences. And there are three types of conditional sentences. Type 1, type 2, and type 3. Now today, you are going to learn about conditional sentences type 1. Your topic is, your lesson is conditional sentences type 1. Okay, now let's examine how conditional sentences type 1 are formed. අපි මේව හැදෙන්නේ කොහොමද කියලා පුතේ ඊළඟට බලමු. Right? Then again, please look at the sentence. If we do regular exercises, we will be healthy. Study the sentence. As you see, there are two parts in this sentence. Can you name them? Can you identify two parts in this sentence? Yes, correct. Very good. If we do regular exercise, this is first part, we will be healthy. This is the second part. There are two parts in conditional sentences and we can name them. We name this part as if clause. If clause. If clause. You see if here and we name them, name this part as if clause. And this part, this clause, we name it as main clause. Okay, Buddha? As you see, there are two parts in a conditional sentence, if clause and main clause. Okay, then api ilangata balamu, කොහොමද මේ if clause එක හැදෙන්නේ කොහොමද main clause එක හැදෙන්නේ කියලා අපි clause එකක් ඉගෙන if conditional sentence එකක් ඉගෙන ගන්නවා කියලා කියන්නේ මේකේ මේ clauses හැදෙන්නේ කොහොමද කියන එක දැනගන්න එකයි okay then let's examine how if clause is formed and how the main clause is formed okay right Huda once again please look at the sentences given in page number 96 pupils book page number 96 look at the examples here okay please go through them if we do regular exercises we will be healthy number 2 if it rains we will get wet number 3 if you drink a lot of milk you will have a strong bones and teeth number 4 if you eat a lot of sweets you will become overweight number 5 if you get wet you will catch a cold 6 if I go to the pharmacy I will buy a roll of bandage okay now tell me look at the second one if it rains we will get wet what's the tell me what is the if clause here yes correct if clause is if it rains we will get wet is the main clause okay third one again tell me what's the if clause exactly if you drink a lot of milk that is the if clause then the rest you will have a strong bones and teeth that is main clause very good okay then fourth one if you eat a lot of sweets what's that yes correct if clause you will become overweight that is the main clause fifth one if you get wet what is it again very good if clause you will catch a cold yes that is the main clause okay now now I think you can identify the identify what the main if clause is and what the main clause is then udalata if conditional sentence ekak if clause ekak saha main clause ekak andura ganna puluwan kiyala mama hitana right okay now then this is today's lesson is on conditional sentence type 1 conditional sentences type 1 so now we are going to learn how the if clause and the main clause are formed okay as given in this example you see how it is formed if clause then think about the tense of the if clause tense what's the tense there very good simple present tense then we do simple present tense and look at the main clause will be healthy then what's the tense yes correct simple future simple future okay දැන් අපි ආයම මතක් කරගමු අපි මේ දක්වා ඉගෙන ගත්ත ටික right now today's lesson is on conditional sentences right there are three types of conditional sentences we call them type 1 type 2 and type 3 today's lesson is on conditional sentences type 1 okay in conditional sentences there are two parts two clauses if clause and main clause right එතකොට අපි මේ conditional sentence එකක් ඉගෙන ගන්නවා කියන්නේ ඒ sentence එකේ තියෙන if clause එක කොහොමද හැදෙන්නේ main clause එක කොහොමද හැදෙන්නේ කියලා දැනගන්න එකයි right in type 1 if clause is formed in using simple present and main clause is formed using simple future right okay then there is another point you have to learn that is using comma using comma how do we use commas in conditional sentences අපිට හැම වෙලේම පුළුවන් ද comma එක පාවිච්චි කරන්න මේ sentences වල එහෙම නැත්නම් කොතනද අපි comma එක පාවිච්චි කරන්නේ right we have to pay attention okay once again please look at the example if we do regular exercises we will be healthy right you can see a comma here now what's the place yes we use commas at the end of the if clause there are two clauses in conditional sentences if clause and main clause so we use commas at the end of the if clause okay then I will write this sentence I will write the same sentence in this way We will be healthy if we do regular exercises. Now what has happened? Yes. Now this is the main clause and this is the if clause. We can write conditional sentences in this way too. Now where is the comma? Where is the comma? Yes it is missing so that is the another point that you have to keep in mind that is we if the main clause comes first we don't use commas okay if the main clause this is the main clause now you can identify this is the main clause if the main clause comes first we don't use commas okay right these are the things that you should learn when you learn conditional sentences okay right then man aayama podda matak karanna api lesson eke monawada igena gatte kiyana eka This is conditional sentences type 1. In conditional sentences, there are two clauses. Yes, please name them. What are they? Very good. If clause and the main clause. In type 1, if clause is formed using simple present tense and the main clause is formed using simple future. And about using commas, we use commas at the end of the if clause. At the end of the if clause. But if the main clause comes first, we don't use commas there. Right? Okay, children. Please turn to page number 97 in your book. 97 in your pupil's book. You can go through the note given there. Learning point. Okay, and look at activity 5 in page number 97. Page 97. Refer to the table and build conditional sentences. Make the necessary punctuation and capitalization changes. Okay. You see a table here. And first, in the first column, you are given the if clause. And in the second column, you can see the main clause. Now you have to match the correct if part and the main clause and make sentences, right? And one more thing to remember, you have to use correct punctuations, full stops, commas, right? Where necessary, you have to use correct punctuations and capitalizations. Then, what do you mean by capitalization? Right? Look at this one. It rains today, they will call off the match. Okay. This is the fourth sentence given in the activity. If it rains and the matching part is they will call off the match. Okay. Then you see there are so many mistakes in punctuations and capitalization. Tell me, what are the mistakes? What are the errors I have done? What is missing here? Exactly, very good. Okay, then you know that this is the if clause in the sentence. If clause in the sentence. So, at the end of this if clause, you have to use what? Yes, comma. Okay, what else? And very important thing that you have remembered, my full stop is missing. So you have to put full stops at the end of the sentence. Ek punchi ka indala ma danna deyak putala. Okay. Is that all? Is that all? Yes. Here it is given I caught at this sentence from the activity, so I used capital T here. Potetti lathiya non capital T vale neda? There it's okay. Then maya inne sentence ekak athule. Can I use capital T here now? No, I can't. Then maya main clause ekak then sentence ekak athulata ewillane. So we can't use capital T. There we have to write simple T. Simple T. Now this has become a one sentence. So I have to use capital T. Okay, please keep it in mind. And one more thing. Let's take the first one. Okay, please read the sentence. If I find your book, I will bring it to you. Again, please tell me what are the punctuations and what are the capitalizations I have to use. Yes, very good. We have to put comma at the end of the if clause. Then full stop at the end of the sentence. Then what about this one? I use simple T instead of capital T here. Right? Now again capital I. So are you going to use simple I here? No, that is wrong, right? You can't use simple I here. Why? Hey, me kya api capital ekak simple karana meka sentence ekata hawa kiyala? Then me capital ekak then simple karama waradi kiyala. What's the reason? Yes, exactly. Then I mama api kotana liyuwat api I liyanne capital wali ya sentence ke athule hitiya mulata awat we write I in capital. So we are not going to use simple I here. Mama simple I? No. Then there you have to use capital I. Mama. Okay, right. Uta denna, this activity says make necessary punctuations, that means commas, full stops and all these things, and capitalizations. Here we use the correct capitalizations. Okay, right. Now please complete activity 5 and turn to activity 6 in page number 98. Here use your own ideas and complete these clauses to form conditional sentences. In this activity, you have to make your own sentences. Okay. In some sentences, main clause is missing. In some other sentences, if clause is missing. So when you write the answer, if you write the main clause, then you have to think, this is main clause, what's the tense I have to use? Ekena kalpanakari wenna. If you write fill the main clause, then you have to use the future. Then if you complete the if clause, there you have to use simple present. Very good. Then think about that. And also, please take out your workbook. Unit 9, Activity 2, page number 56. Page 56. Complete the sentences using the words given in brackets. Here there are 5 sentences and you are given some phrases in brackets. You have to use these phrases in the blank. There you have to form, sometimes you have all. Here you have to complete the main clause only. In this activity, you have to complete the main clause. And activity 3. Read the utterances in activity 4 of the pupil's book. That means this one. Mulin meka puthe kiyawala inna one. Activity 4. Utterances, sentences given in activity 4. And categorize the sentences under the headings simple present tense, simple future tense. දැන් අපි lesson එක පටන් ගන්නකොටම කරා වගේ මේ utterances අපිට කොටස් දෙකකට බෙදන්න වෙනවා. As simple present and simple future. අපි මේ වගේ නඳුන ගන්න ඕනේ what the simple present part and the what the simple future part is. වෙන වචන වලින් කියුවොත් what the if clause is and what the main clause is. Okay. Right. Now I hope now you can understand what conditional sentences type 1 is. Okay. පුතේ ආයෙම අපි summary එකක් මතක් කරගමු අපි සාරාංශයක් අදාගමු. Now this lesson was on conditional sentences type 1. There are 3 types. Type 1, type 2, type 3. ඒකෙන් අපි ඉගෙන ගත්තේ conditional sentences type 1. Right? ඊළඟ කාරණේ තමයි conditional sentences can be divided into 2 parts. Right? If clause, main clause. Then if clause is formed in simple present tense and the main clause is formed in simple future tense. Okay, that is the first point. And the second point is using comma. We have to use commas in conditional sentences. කොහොමද අපි comma එක use කරන්නේ? Yes, at the end of the if clause. නමුත් එයා මුලින් ආවොත් තමයි අපි comma එකක් use කරන්නේ. Right, if the main clause comes first, there we do not use the comma. ඔන්නෝ ටික තමයි පුතේ conditional sentences type 1 යටතේ ඔයාලා ඉගෙන ගන්න ඕනේ. මම හිතනවා දැන් ඔයාලට මේ දේවල් ටික පැහැදිලි කියලා. Please do your homework. Please complete the activities I gave you in the pupils book as well as in the workbook. Please do complete them at home. I hope you enjoy the lesson and hope to see you again. Thank you for joining us.